500,000 visitors are expected during the 10 days of Motor Fair, and more than 200 exhibitors hope to sell £9 million worth of cars. That's what makes Motor Fair so different from the Birmingham Motor Show. There the cars are for looking at, here they are for sale. Earl's Court is in the final stages of a major renovation scheme. What do the show's organisers think of the new look?
I think it's a great improvement. I mean, the old girl's been here for a long time and she needed a facelift. And we've spent, between the GLC and ourselves, we've spent £10 million on her, and I think it's beginning to show.
Do you think London really is the appropriate place for this sort of show?
Yes, I do. I think the capital city is very much the right place, and the southeast of England really needs a motoring shop window every so often, and this is it.
For those in search of fantasy, there's a new Porsche, or the welcoming open doors on the Rolls-Royce stand. This Camargue is yours for just £83,000. More to the point, though, the new Vauxhall Cavalier. Next year, 65,000 of them will be built at Luton. What does the new car mean to the company?
It is extremely important because, obviously, we needed a new car to fill our car assembly plant in the Luton factory, and we employ between 3,000 and 4,000 people in that plant. We are inundated with orders for it, and we're working full time there where we've been on short time previously.
The object of Motor Fair is to sell cars, and ultimately that means saving jobs. Roger Parry for Thames News.